Good morning, everyone. I hope you had a wonderful day so far. I am Rajnikant, and I lead the EMEA business for Digital Transformation Solution.
Hello, everyone. It is great to be speaking with all of you today. My name is Ashish Kakani. I am Senior Director of Engineering, and I head the industrial business.
Today, we will showcase how Harman is helping build safer, smarter, and sustainable communities enabled by the smart techs. Let me start with a quick introduction about Harman. Harman is a 100% wholly owned subsidiary of Samsung with 30,000 plus professionals in 30 different countries. We are having three major businesses: automotive, lifestyle audio, brands such as Harman Kardon, JBL, AKG, to name a few, and a digital transformation solution, the unit which I belong to. We connect deep human and business insights with the possibilities of technology to enhance life's experience that can make healthier, safer, productive, and more rewarding. We are simplifying the way people interact with the technology and connect to the world around them. In our digital transformation solution, we don't just deliver a new piece of technology, but focus on what it can do for you in offering solution for creating people first outcome by leveraging business consulting, award-winning design agency, and technology powerhouse. We call this approach Harman's Lifeware. Our Lifeware solution for smarter connectivity in telecom, for smarter and sustainable communities in industrial, and Lifeware solution for better living for healthcare, transforming people's everyday lives. Here is Lifeware for you.
Great technology can't just work on its own anymore. It has to be one cohesive whole. We believe technology is at its best when it all works together. We partner with visionary clients who are reimagining what technology can do. It is our job to bring those visionary ideas to life. We do that by blending the physical and digital and making them more human, by creating dynamic technology solutions that can serve ever-changing human needs. We know we'll be ready. At Harman, we don't just create new hardware and software. We create technology-led solutions that transforms the everyday experience. That's what we call Lifeware. We create and deliver Lifeware through our unique digital transformation capabilities, our people, our platforms, our domain expertise, our robust processes, and our delivery excellence. Harman Digital Transformation Solutions, delivering better customer-centric solutions to transform everyday life and experiences.
Thanks, Rajni, for introducing Harman Digital Transformation Solutions. Technology is at the core of every growing business, and industries are going through massive digital transformation in verticals like industrial automation, healthcare, telecom. If we observe industry trends, there is a lot of focus on optimizing resources, increasing productivity, and provide comfort and safety to end consumers with connected ecosystem, which can enhance their lifestyle and also help optimizing resources. Cost management and connected health is at the topmost priority for hospitals. Optimal asset utilization and remote monitoring is becoming essential in today's world. Worker safety, productivity is of paramount importance. Supply chain automation and optimization is critical, and while organizations are focusing on addressing some of these, there is a disruption happening with 5G, which will enable most complex use cases implementation possible with low latency and high bandwidth availability. Harman is at forefront in addressing some of these industry challenges with its SmartX offering, which focuses on smart health, smart factory, smart buildings, and smart transportation. In smart health, we enable better living with virtual care, health IoT, and connected fitness solutions. Our extended remote care platform and patient engagement solutions deliver better outcomes and better patient experiences. Our health IoT solution helps modernize and connect the healthcare products and systems for reduced care cost and better clinician experiences. And our connected fitness solution transform fitness equipments like treadmill and stationary bikes to be safer, smarter, connected, and entertaining. In Smart Factory, industry is focusing on connecting assets, move the data to cloud, and take advantage of AI technologies for reducing downtime and improve productivity. We are building connected system which can help in planning from shop floor to top floor. We are implementing predictive maintenance at the edge, connecting machines, MES systems, and ERP systems for better planning and tracking, building centralized command center to monitor global assets from one single location, and with most matured systems, embarking on a journey to implement digital twin systems. We are bringing a lot of solutions for workers. For worker safety, we have used various sensors and variables. We have used image processing to ensure safety gears are wear properly, monitoring assets on the ground so that the workers are not near to them. From productivity aspects, we have built AR/VR-based training modules, quality inspection systems, and we have built lightweight customized AR/VR headset for easy usage. Moving to smart buildings, safety is most critical aspect apart from optimizing the energy usage. For safety of people in COVID times, we have integrated our track and trace solution with product of leading brands in building automation. We are working on access control system, fire safety system, and video management systems extensively and building several products in this area for our customers. We have transformed legacy systems, which are predominantly on-prem systems, with re-architecting them with microservices-based architecture and moving it to cloud. We have implemented AI-based systems for safety and security, focus on energy conservation with optimizing HVAC systems, lighting systems, and most importantly, connecting it to smart grid ecosystem. Harman has great experience working with some of the large smart metering companies, and we continue to contribute to AMI and smart grid space. In the area of smart transportation, focus is on use cases like smart toll booth, smart parking solutions, smart traffic signals, pedestrian safety. Harman has done recent acquisition in smart transportation and are already piloting 5G use cases. Harman is building its own IP and can participate in building customer solutions for smart city initiative. Our smart transportation solution can also be integrated into a larger smart city ecosystem. Harman provides chip-to-cloud technology solution with unique proposition with Harman's award-winning design agency, Human. Harman has a capability from hardware design, firmware development, building and manufacturing hardware with strong ODM ecosystem, competency in cloud platforms, and strong analytics practice. Harman has a dedicated advanced technology practice which focus on AI technologies like AR/VR, RPA, blockchain, to name a few. Harman has its own IP and assets for connected ecosystem, which can help accelerating IoT journey for our customers with device management solution, patented Delta OTA technology, NLP engine, video surveillance platform with advanced AI techniques, connectivity solution with gateway variants, and many more. Harman is constantly investing in building new solutions and recently launched 5G test lab. Now it is important to look at real-time problems we have solved for our customers, and I'll be taking you through one of the case study, and I'm sure each one of you can relate to it. Harman is focusing a lot on IoT 4.0 and got an opportunity to implement IoT 4.0 for one of the leading agritech company and realizing the vision from farm to command center with digital twin capabilities. Customer was not having any visibility from the farms on how the seeds production lines are working across various geographies. There is a lot of dependence on manual inputs, and asset utilization and tracking was also an issue. Due to changing parameters like moisture, temperature, quality of seeds were also impacting. Customer wanted to build an IoT platform where requirement is to view all these activities happening across multi-geography through one single command center, addressing various KPIs depending upon the role of the people in the organization. In future, ultimate goal is to use AI technologies for effective decision-making and which can enhance the quality of the product, improve asset utilization, and increase productivity. Harman took a consultative approach and exercised multiple workshops with the key stakeholders from client side, along with human team. Human team has a people who are, you know, psychologists, who are from different ethnicity, and who can understand what users are really looking for. Harman has defined the overall architecture blueprint based on the inputs gathered over 2 months of extensive brainstorming and research, and taken MVP approach to implement features to realize the part of vision faster with safe agile practices. Going to more specific details of the architecture, the key requirement from customer was to have highly scalable architecture, keeping in mind the future requirements on bringing more and more assets to the single IoT platform. Apart from scalability, security was also a key requirement, and need not to say, great user experience is key to adoption of this platform and successful rollout. Focusing on the left-hand side, where Harman has deployed its own edge gateway with implementation of OPC UA standards for collecting the data from PLCs of machines, additional sensors have been deployed and has capability to do the edge computing like image processing at the edge. Gateway is connected through Wi-Fi to cloud system and has the capability to connect through GSM network as well. The platform is built with a lot of flexibility so that any assets in the future can be onboarded to the platform seamlessly. There were a lot of integrations with external systems through common data lake is been achieved. At the core of the platform, high volume data ingestion is key, and we have used AWS IoT Core Engine and AWS Stack as the core of the platform. Entire system is designed based on microservices architecture principles, configurable event framework and rules engine, scalable data model and responsive UI design principles, keeping in mind the various personas who are going to use the system. For effective execution of the program, DevOps toolchain was set up, use of Kubernetes to full-fledged container orchestration services, and simplification of microservices deployment. Harman has followed safe agile principles for effective execution of the program. This approach has helped us with fail early scenarios, and we were able to take corrective actions. Harman has deployed its people on customer sites for effective implementation and communication as well. So in summary, we were able to connect assets from the farm, such as feeder, seed processing unit, harvester, through PLCs and attach some additional sensors and gateways to push the data in near real time to cloud. We have defined various dashboards for key KPIs for different personas and implemented first level of digital twin, which is a pervasive twin. So in summary, value delivered to the customer are both tangible and intangible. For tangible outcomes, focus is on improving asset utilization, improving productivity and operational cost, to name a few. And for intangible outcome is to elevate the entire user experience, ease of access to the information, and making whole system very, very interactive. So in nutshell, Harman has delivered on its capabilities of connecting the larger ecosystem and bring data to the centralized command center. So with this, I'll say thank you for listening in to our presentation. Thank you.
Let's get started. So there are a lot of questions that have come up in the chat, Ashish. This is a very interesting presentation that you guys did. The first question, Ashish, that I have is, how does Harman specifically help with driving a culture change across people, process, and governance, even as you know the technology that you reference is being used for smart cities, because this is not just about technology?
Thanks, Edu. This is a very interesting question, right? And change is inevitable, right? As companies are facing disruptions with the new entrants who are more agile, more bringing more innovative business models. And, there is a lot of pressure on the productivity and bringing the products faster to the market, right, for the established players. To address these challenges, organizations are trying to adopt new technology. Human element is key to successful implementation of these initiatives, right, as we are talking about people aspect here. Any change call for shift in culture, skill development, and new ways of working, and obviously strengthening governance process across. Going into more specific of cultural change, lack of digital culture and training is the biggest challenge for the companies. Culture of cooperation across the organization is very important to drive the optimum solution, right? Because multiple departments needs to interact for realizing the full potential. Organizations have to develop incentive structure to drive these changes in the workforce, right? And also getting worker training done in more interactive and fun way is important. And organizations, HR has to think creatively to drive this change. As organizations are embarking on a digital journey, there is bound to be a lot of process change which will come into picture. The old way of working is replaced by more optimized processes, but can also involve complications of having other departments involved in driving this change. These changes needs to be handled carefully, right? bringing change to the organization has to be inclusive process. If the process is inclusive, then change becomes that much more easy and meaningful. For example, you know, Harman's Human, which is an in-house design agency, brings that advantage while we drive digital transformation for our customers. This team has a people from different ethnicity, has psychologists who will drive the inclusive process with people, get them involved, understand their issues and challenges, and build solutions accordingly. We have seen great results by this inclusivity as it drives ownership among people. So while all of above is happening, culture is changing, new processes are evolving, right, over a period of time. And to drive this effectively would need very strong governance structure. So there are two aspects to governance structure. One is how you focus on the governance on implementing the solutions and drive the KRAs and KPI. But more importantly, the governance here is more about, you know, how we govern the data, because these are all, data-driven systems as we transitioning to the IoT world, right? So concerns about data security, customer approval of data use, and an uncertain legal environment prevent the many firms from unlocking the power of their data, right? And this is where, you know, they need to be careful, and they need a strong governance framework which enables organization unlock the power of this data without compromising on security and other legal requirements. So I have touched upon, some of these, aspects, how organization needs to think when they talk about people, process, and governance. Yadu.
That's a wonderful response, Ashish. Actually, let me shift gears and move to Rajni. Rajni, the volume of data that is being generated, you know, based on the solutions that you're deploying is very, very large. How are you guys expecting enterprises and cities to actually manage this in a more sustainable way? Rajni.
So certainly, and I think it's all about also getting the insight out of the data. So it's, if you really ask me, in today's world, data is collected from every action we perform, every device we use. And it's the trend which is getting generated from this data collected over time. The challenges has been in terms of getting the right amount of data in order to perform and identify the trends. For organizations, mainly like, say, even us, who is able to has a solution to deploy, perform data analysis, deploy the identify the patterns, predict future trends and products, means it is helpful, because how you take the data in order to define those patterns and then trends and products. In Harman also, we had the similar challenge because we were getting the multiple sources of this data for the connected car. That was one of the division. So in to address the problem of the data and give the meaningful insight and experience to the consumer, Harman launched an IoT platform way back in 2018, which is called Ignite Platform. This platform was launched for mainly initial in the earlier years for the connected vehicles, which basically enables the OEM to develop and manage and operate their own in-vehicle store. But the later we realized that this platform can be extended to anything. In fact, it's a service delivery platform enables the connectivity, device management, application, if you want to enable any third-party application, analytics, cybersecurity, and of course, it gave the managed services capabilities in a SaaS model. And we thought it's a perfect one. We can take this now. This is already built in some Harman IP. It's a platform existing. How do we take this to our enterprise customer into the other vertical as well? And that's when we extended this, the functionality and capabilities of this platform to work more like a domain agnostic IoT platform for the various use cases. This is basically, the platform has been designed to manage such volume of data using like message queue, persistent storage, and of course, like with a easy integration of the APIs and the other external applications. It's purely built on the microservices architecture. So definitely what we have done internally is like, and we are extending this to the other the customer, we are just using the and helping the OEMs to other enterprise customer with the Ignite platform, which will help them perform all the data collection, aggregation, modeling, recommendation, visualization, name anything you need it, and generate the meaningful
insight information and manage the data. Storage is not an issue anyway. So I think for us, like the answer to from Harman is more like the platform is already ready for the use.
Thank you, Rajni. That's a wonderful response. The next set of questions are slightly different to what you, Rajni, and Ashish have covered. I did bump into Nigam backstage. So very, very briefly, Nigam's the Director of Product Management at Harman Digital Transformation Solutions. Most of his experience has been in the telecom industry, and he leads the smart cities business. So Nigam, I suspect you have a friend in the audience who's pasted these questions. Why should we, as enterprises, be interested in smart cities and smart buildings? And there is a second question associated. Enterprises have a limited budget, but they know that smart buildings would be critical in managing their real estate going forward. How do enterprises fund such an exercise? So Nigam, over to you.
Right. Thanks, Yadu. Yeah, and you said it right. Initially, I'm not wearing a jacket because it's 45 degrees here. So trying to keep cold. So I'll take the first question, which is the why should then well there be interest in smart cities and smart buildings to enterprises? So well, actually, smart cities, smart buildings, they are no longer buzzwords. Maybe 2-3 years before, they would seem more like, yes, somebody's trying to go into a digital domain, so or rather ride the digital bandwagon. Today, these are not no longer buzzwords. They are actually a reality. And they're fast becoming the new normal. And for any enterprise which is actually looking at moving into a digital transformation journey and receive tangible benefits from these particular technologies, I think it is anyways a must. And not just saying that because everybody is doing it, so well, we should also do it or somebody else should also do it. There are tangible benefits which one receives because of these technologies. And I'll take a few examples there. So in a particular, and I'll take a very simple example of parking solution. So parking solution is one of the, let's say, most talked about and most asked solution in a smart city environment. And it will apply to, a venue also. Venue is basically a miniaturized version of a city. When you say, let's say, stadium or a bigger factory, something, it will apply. Now, what does a parking solution does? Everybody looks at parking that there's a parking lot. In the parking lot, the vehicle comes in, the vehicle takes a ticket, moves in, at the exit, when going out, you pay the money and the ticket gives you the time and the person moves out. The whole scenario of parking management actually is concentrated towards the lot management. The scenario I explained is the user behavior, but it is considered as a default thing. People look at parking as parking spaces management. And that is considered that how many spaces are available, how many are occupied, and that's it. And take this, and I extend this solution with a very simple functionality and say, as a user, what is the benefit that I get out of it? I just know that in a parking space, there are certain empty slots which can be used or it can be made available to me if I reach there in time. Now, I extend the functionality to say that when I start my journey from home, on my way, about 30 minutes away from the destination, I'm actually able to use the mobile app and do a booking. I can book a slot for myself. So that booking gives me the peace of mind that once I reach that particular destination, I will have a slot available. I will not have to wait in outside the building in a queue because it got filled by the time I reached there. And if it's filled up, I can actually go into a next parking lot in an adjoining building. What is the tangible benefit city receives out of it? There is no waiting. People get to know much in advance. So if there's no waiting, there's no idling, there's no burning of fuel standing on the road, there's no wastage of time, there's no wastage of, let's say, resources. And city becomes more greener in terms of burning less fuel. Very simple use case extension gives a lot of tangible benefits to the city. Take the example of a building. A building would have multiple solutions like HVAC, AC, and I'm just taking the macro versions, lighting, HVAC, AC. you extend. Now, is it possible physically in a large building with, let's say, maybe, I don't know, 10 story, 20 story, 40 story building with few hundred conference rooms? No one can actually go in each and every room and check that, are the lights okay? Is the room empty? Switch it off. Do the automation of the solution. Every empty room, the lights will automatically switch off. In a large room, if there's less number of people sitting, the lights will only be switched on in a certain section of the room where the people are sitting. Control the flow of AC.
I'm so sorry to stop you. I'm getting things from production. Guys, yeah. That was so good. What I suggest is, why don't we set up these one-to-ones, carry the conversation going, because it's such a great and interesting topic. So if we get on the system, book those one-to-ones, and thank you very much. That was so great so far. But yeah, I'm afraid we'll have to move on to the next session. So thank you very much, though, for your Q&A session, Harman team.